Steve, I really appreciate you asking me to cut it short right there at the last second. After following these other guys, I didn't want to come up here. But anyway, what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try to tell you guys about the Class A 1972 Final Four football team. First, I'm going to tell you what everybody thought. They weren't supposed to be there. And I'm going to tell you why they weren't supposed to be there. Number one, they didn't have enough size. Okay? Number two, they didn't have enough speed. And number three, there wasn't enough of them. And all you got to do is open up your little program there and count, and you can see how many there were, about 23 or 24 of them. And as far as the size deal, I've been around a lot of peewee football teams, and so far I think I'm up to four sixth grade lines that were bigger than our starting offensive line. Okay? And as far as the speed deal, we had two sophomores that they timed with a stopwatch. That'd be Murdoch and Tom, and the rest of us they timed with a sundial. Okay? So I really want to thank the Hall of Fame committee. Hey, you knocked it out of the park again this year. Hey, what a great bunch of people. What a great bunch of people in this little old town that's gone out and had an effect on the world. What a great job. I want to thank Steve. I want to thank you for asking me to do this. And at first, I turned him down because I just thought, Tom Emmons has got to do this. He's a better speaker. Probably do a lot better job. And then I got to thinking, hey, I've been talking about these guys all my life. And now I'd like to get up and talk about them in front of them. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of start from the very beginning. And I'm going to run through that real quick. And then I'm going to make some comments from our football coach. And then I'm going to end it up with a little story and get out of your hair. So it all started in junior high. Everybody that was on this team, they had to go through two guys in junior high. Coach Don Mike Mayer, Coach Gene Davis. And their somewhat extreme idea of what conditioning was. Everyone had to learn that. And I think through junior high, you don't remember anything, but you remember what we came away with. And I think there was three things. Number one, we were going to be in better condition, and we were going to execute our offense and defense better than any of our opponents. Number two, if our opponents don't score, they can't win. And number three was, we don't lose to a token. Jump to 1968 season, and we got to watch the 68 football team demonstrate some of those things. And when they chewed up yardage with Tommy Loudermilk and Eddie Anglin throwing passes, and we're sitting over there saying, we want to be them. We want to be them. And we got to watch these guys have six straight shutouts. Six straight shutouts. They were our heroes. We wanted to be where they were. We weren't under bleachers playing football. We were there watching. When they huddled up and somebody said, what's our offense? What was it, guys? Oh, bashful. Cannibals. Oh. And when they huddled up, they said, what's our defense? Headhunters. And we ate it up. We couldn't wait to be them. And then, 1969 season, our freshman season, everything started coming together. Of course, all the guys that were underneath us in 72, they were having good junior high years. Went 7-1 as a freshman team. Our only loss was the first game of the year with McAllister. You know, I don't know why Coach Mayer didn't go ahead and schedule Ada and Durant too. You know, he made up for it in later years. We played Durant 2 years in a row in high school. But one of the things that happened at the very end of our freshman season, I sure wish Coach Davis was here. He walked into our locker room in the back of the old gymnasium over there. You remember where we dressed? And then you ran to the And I don't remember everything he said, but I've never forgot these words that he said, and these are the words. If you stay together, if you keep working hard, you will have a chance to play for a state championship. You remember that. You remember that. You go, as I'm going on through here, you remember that. And you remember, they don't score, they can't win. Okay? Jump to 1971 season, when the 72 seniors were juniors, and on down. Had a good senior class led by Dwayne Lawson and Jimmy Humphrey and Tony Davenport. Good guys, and we needed good leaders that year. But Rowan, you talk about lose. You want to hear about lose? Here's how this season started. Oh, by the way, I got to throw this in. Coach Parkhill showed up that year. Bob Parkhill came in as the offensive defensive line coach and as the head basketball coach. He was also a part-time middle linebacker on the scout defense. Okay? And I know you guys remember him over there, about 2'10". Didn't need any shoulder pads, barred somebody's helmet, playing middle linebacker against our starting offense. That was great times right there. That was great times. But here's how the season started in 1971. Our first scrimmage was with, our scrimmage was with Eufaula. And they had a couple of guys named Selman. Leroy and Dewey Selman were still there. And 1 year from that date, they would be starting on the defensive line for the University of Oklahoma. So, you know, they were okay. And it was beaten. And I'm going to come back to that later. Our first game was with Stigler. And Stigler won the district that Eufaula was in. Stigler was okay. Stigler actually ended up beating Atoka in the quarterfinals in Class 2A, the class above us. Eufaula's Class 2A. Stigler's Class 2A. Stigler actually went to the state semifinals in the class above us. They got beat 14-14 by Jinx. Okay? Pretty tough class. That was our second loss in row. Lost our first game. Second game, we lost to Sulphur. Did not score. Third game, we played the heck out of Durant for a half. Nothing to nothing at halftime. I think we ended up getting beat 26-0. There's only 24 of us. They had lots more than that. Okay? But here's what was happening. These guys on this team didn't just take all those words as words. They took them to heart. These guys bought in. Okay? These seniors wouldn't let us get down. We wouldn't let ourselves get down. We went on, we won a couple of games in a row, lost to Atoka, and we lost our patches. That's how important it was to Coach Mayer that we not lose. If you went undefeated for 3 straight years against Atoka, you got a patch for your letter jacket that said, never lost to Atoka. Coach Mayer was serious about that. He was serious about a lot of stuff, and he spoke plain words, but he went to your heart. If you wanted to take it to your heart, he went right there. Okay? Bring up some about Coach Park here. And our other coaches, they were all from Southeastern. I don't know what the deal was about Southeastern and conditioning until I finally looked it up, I Googled it. And back years ago, there was one class that every prospective coach had to pass before he could become a teacher and a coach, or a coach. And that class was called Run Their Butts Until They Think They're Going to Die. Okay? And then they had to follow it up the second semester with one that said, Stop Before They Do. But anyway, you get the drift, and apparently Southeastern was still that way when you went through there, Chris. So, anyway, junior year, ended up making a goal line stand against Tishomingo for the district championship. We were beat if they scored. They had to score, they had the ball inside the 5-yard line. First down, had to stop 4 plays, and we did, and we won the district championship. And as a reward for that, we got to go play Bayan at Bayan. Bayan was 15-0 that year, 14-0 state champions. And they beat us pretty good. But I'm going to tell you what, about 2-3 minutes right before half, it was a 14-6 football game. Okay? So we learned something. We learned we could play with the best. And everything these guys did, they're sitting among you, they learned something. The next year, a lot of excitement in the air. Of course, after that junior year, you know, whatever doesn't kill you makes you stronger, right? So we're all pumped up, the girls are pumped up. I was going back reading through some of the old yearbooks. Every girl was talking about athletic season next year. And by the way, Susie, thanks for putting that together this afternoon. That was great. You got to see a bunch of people I hadn't seen in a long time. Thank you all for coming. That was super. I really liked that. So anyway, what I'm going to do now, tried to think of what to say, and I can't say it any better than our coach did. The first quotes I'm going to read are out of the Ada News. And this is following the Bayan game where we knocked off the defending state champion, shut them out, stopped the 24-25 game winning streak. This is after going into the season, not favored to win the district, picked second in the district behind Craig, beat Craig 26-0, came up against 8-0 Conwall, beat Conwall 30-something-0. Went through a pretty good season. Pretty hard to cover it all. Jack Bryan, you covered it all. Thank you, sir. Every game in the Coalgate paper, man, thank you. That was a great article you did about these guys. Thank you very much. Here's Coach Mayer being interviewed. As the Wildcats continue their scoreless binge against Class A opposition, fiery Coach Mayer is the man responsible for the rock hard Coalgate defense. He said, "Our theory is that it's hard to lose when you don't give up any points." He told us that in the seventh grade, right? "We've always taken great pride in playing good defense, and this bunch of kids has done it better than it's ever been done before here. The best team Coalgate ever had, 1968, shut out six teams. This game makes eight for us." Mayer says this win must raise the highlight of Colgate's football history. "To our knowledge, Colgate has never been this far and never knocked off the number one team in the state. The coach wouldn't single out anybody for additional praise after the game. He said, name them all. Name them all. Stick together." After the loss in the semifinals, here's what he had to say. "Mayer described this year's team as having the finest team spirit I've seen on a high school team. I think that the biggest thing about them, all of them, Mayer said, they never quit. They didn't even quit when Hominy had them down by 20 points and a touchdown wouldn't have made any difference. They went out and moved the ball. They're real champions and will always be to me. I coached a lot of fine boys and players. We have not had any complete team with better team spirit than this team. Everybody was pulling for everybody else, and I'm proud also that so many of our former players were pulling for them too. Those guys from that 68 team, they were behind us that whole season. They were coming to games. How proud he made us. That was so great. And now here's what I think about this football team. And I got a pretty good story here. Going back to that New Falls scrimmage, I know this is long, Steve, but they don't have anything else to do. Going back to that New Falls scrimmage, junior year, and like I said, this was almost from junior high on through like the stars aligning. Because these guys, like I said, we're not supposed to be there. usually the first play of any ball game started with a play called 36 power, high right 36 power. And the quarterback took the snap, and he turned, and the fullback and halfback led through the hole, and he handed off the tailback, and they followed him through. Well, the first play against Eufaula, Coach Merritt decided to call 36 power pass. Same play, except you fake it to the tailback. And in this case, it was me faking to Tony Davenport. Alan Leary was running an out cut and then turning up the field. After you hide the ball and carry out your fake a little bit, you raise up, and Alan's wide open down there. Okay? So here we go, Hutt. I step back, I fake to Tony Davenport, and I don't know which one of Selman's hit me, but I never got my head turned back around. Flat. Face first into the grass. Go back to the huddle, and my offensive linemen are picking, you know, like you see on TV every once in a while? Offensive linemen are picking grass out of my face. Just got buried. And the rest of the scrimmage didn't get any better than that, really. I think it was like 45 to nothing. It was brutal. Okay? So we shake hands and we're walking off the field, you know, and I'm dragging my butt off the field because one of the Selmans actually lined up at fullback on offense. And these guys' thighs were bigger than my waist at the time. These guys were a load, but we hit them all night long. We just didn't do much with them. But anyway, I'm dragging my butt back to the bus. And here comes Jim Johnson walking by me. He's laughing his butt off, and I'm like, what's the matter with you? We just got killed. And he kind of came over to me and he said, oh, we were shaking hands, and I shook hands with that big blankety blank that was lined up in front of me all night, one of the Selmans. And when we shook hands, he said, you little blankety blank, you've been hitting me in the ankles all night long. That's how I've always thought about you guys. If you was big enough to hit somebody in the mouth, you'd hit them in the mouth. If you wasn't, you'd hit them in the knees. If that wasn't enough, you'd hit them in the ankles. And I'm so proud to have played the game with you. And I wish I could start naming off everybody. I couldn't have got my stories in if I did. But just know that to me, that was a complete team. And in practice, same thing. In fact, I blew my punchline. Because I said, hit him in the ankles. I was going to say, well, that just like in practice. And I don't know how many of you guys have told me over the years, you know, games never seemed that bad because of the practices we went through. And we hit each other in practice. And we walked off friends every day. And it was a great experience. I've relived it so many times over the years. And I thank you, Steve, for giving the opportunity to share it. And I thank everybody that's been here tonight. And I hope you have a safe trip home. And like I said, go Cats.
Bridget, you just know, and it didn't matter. But anyway,